Well, we're here, right? What are you seeing on that? Do you see your balls? That means your pants are off, and that means you're out of line. Get out of here. CAO, new to me, maybe new to you, the V23. I think the original was the V19. Then there's a 21. I don't remember, doesn't matter. But here's the thing though. CAO is a massive brand, which out of any of the brands out there, CAO does a great job of not being CAO. What I mean is, you can't tell me what kind of brand CAO is. CAO does more different stuff than any brand, I think, ever in the cigar industry. So if you like CAO, maybe you're into kinky stuff. It's fair. CAO does whatever they want, you know, and whether you love them, hate them, or indifferent, you know, try them time to time. They have the most range using different kinds of blends and tobaccos, concepts, really. I mean, I enjoy their brand. It's not my favorite, but it's a fun, it's like a R&D brand, like research, where it's always doing different shit. Some of it sticks, some doesn't, but who cares? Can't all be winners. This is a full-size big boy, 6x60. Honduran wrapper, Nicaraguan Habano binder, and then Brazilian Nicaraguan Habano, and there's multiple Nicaraguans in the filler. Not people, okay? I'm not Diddy, but I'm not kidnapping anyone. And it's slightly windy. I don't have a jacket, but it's beautiful. It's like 70, 69 degrees. What a beautiful fall. I mean, we're getting, thank you, God. Look at that, what a nice looking stick. $13, Pennsylvania. It's gonna cost more where you are, though, because you got taxed. Oh, shit. Okay. Here comes the wind. I gotta give a second. If you want wind to come, try to light a match. This is a big cigar. Really nice looking wrapper. Really impressive. A reddish brown hue. Like sharp with like a bright little, like almost like crystals in the wrapper. What a tremendous cigar. I'm not even like halfway lit. It's always harder lighting in the day, I don't know why. Is what it is. What a tremendous cigar. Even with box pressing. This is 6x60. It feels even, I don't know, feels bigger than 6x60. That's what she said. Medium plus off the bat. Very nice, generous amount of flavor. Tingling, sweet and spices. Flavor is moving. Wowza. That's enjoyable, that's likable, that's a lot of character. Flavor is lively. I would consider this a strong cigar off the bat, being the size and the length. If it's like that off the first initial puff, we're gonna get to medium full real quick. Just like me and your sister. See? Are you going medium full with my mom? Tell me the truth. No, man. Okay. I took her full AJ. Oh no! It's a joke. I should stop saying this ridiculous nonsense. Just trying to make a cheap laugh. Long, heavy finish. And I don't know what other size of this cigar. I like this cigar. This cigar's a winner. Fantastic looking. Good price for like a really upper mid-tier cigar. And look and feel in the box is beautiful. That's a great profile. That's a great profile. You know, and it is what it is. Is we gonna fuck with Richie? You wanna fuck with me? You wanna fuck with me, man? You wanna fuck with me? You wanna fuck with me? Huh? Huh? Let's see. Let's see. Come on. Let's go. Let's go, huh? You wanna go? No? Hmm? Huh? 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 It's all fun and games, right? Until you lose some teeth. Listen, I'm just kidding. I'm kind of fired up. I'm in the sun. I actually love this cigar. First time having it, I would smoke that again. I'd prefer it in fucking Robusto. Flavor's fantastic. We're at medium fall right there. Long finish. Rich notes coffee. Some earth. Mixture of cedar and charred wood. It's got a lot of depth with that note. A lot of black pepper. There's a lot of flavor in this. A lot of fun, lively, strong, without going nuts or super dark. 70% darkness. And the cigar doesn't feel like a Maduro, really. Which it was listed as. Doesn't really feel like some dark sun growing. Obviously it's growing in the sun, but how it's listed. Doesn't feel like really Habano. It's definitely not a shade. Whatever it is, I'm talking about how the cigar is being pushed. And I think CEO knows how to make things unique. They take a lot of risk. You look at the flathead line, which I enjoy. There's still business in the cigar. Flathead line's gonna be around what? Almost 10 years? Has it been 10 years? People smoke them. They're enjoyable, medium plus cigars. And they're nice looking. And of course, you buy online, you can get a better price. Nothing bad to say. I'm gonna come back here. We're at a real solid medium full. Rich, sugary. Cinnamon spices, black, red pepper. Dude, look, this cigar, maybe it's the whole mix and the type of cigar, tobacco, and the wrapper, and how they're pushing it, and all the different type of different Nicaraguan, Honduran tobacco using this thing, and Brazilian. Which, what other cigar uses that type of blend? Brazilian and the filler, and Honduran and Nicaraguan. Fucking League of Number Nine. It's kind of like a League of Number Nine with a Honduran wrapper. Dude, this cigar is a fucking winner. It's a winner. Now, if you don't want this big size, go for it smaller. But the fact that I'm really enjoying this in this big size, I think the flavor would be even more intense. That's about kind of a big, doofy cigar in a Robusto or Toro. However, though, can you enjoy this big, kind of doofy cigar? Yeah. $13 PA, it's going to cost more where you're at, but really enjoyable. I mean, I'm done talking with the flavor. Listen, if you like flavor, it's pretty much got everything. Like, it's just very complex, and it's all working. Nothing bad to say about it. Nothing bad to say. It's not a godlike cigar, but somewhere between very good and amazing. I'm really, and that's in 6x60. This cigar is gonna land anywhere between a 4.5 and a 4.7. Really enjoyable. Solid cigar, I'll come back. Nothing bad to say about it. I'm not mad. Well, I guess down to the last third. Tremendous cigar. Really enjoyed it. It's gonna be a 4.6. Solid, enjoyable. I think anyone could enjoy this. A nice medium full, a lot of complex flavor. nice amount of spice and complex spice, but really nice charred wood and cedar. And on top of that, such complex sweetness with this raw sugar, but then it's like a really nice fruit citrus note. It's a mix between like almost like orange citrus and lemon citrus. It's really nice. And it just gets more prominent the more you smoke it. It's better than I thought it was going to be. For a big blend, looks like a big stupid cigar, box press, 6x60. Yeah, bro, this is enjoyable. Almost delicious, I must say. And you know what? A unique blend that doesn't feel like any other cigar. So if you're looking for something really complex, 3/4 strength, 70% darkness, and if you're looking for something you don't want a Maduro, like a classic San Andreas or a classic Connecticut Burley Maduro, or you don't want some type of Habano spiciness, a lot of earth, or you know, whatever, or some type of Echo and Sumatra, this Honduran wrapper with this blend is fucking phenomenal. The Honduran tobacco gets the least respect, but there's a lot of Honduran tobacco in this, in the wrapper, and then obviously in the filler. And Nicaraguan as well, and Brazilian, but the whole thing works. The bottom line is the cigar work, but there's the blend total with the wrapper and the size and the construction, does it work? And then how about the price point? So yeah, it's not like an extreme high value. It's expensive for mid-tier, 13 and change for mid-tier. Pennsylvania is gonna be more where you're at. Could be 15 to 20 with taxes. But if you can get these for a good price, yeah, I definitely would try it. And if anything, it's just good to put the content out there. You might never smoke this, but at least you know exists. At least you know the review on it. Obviously, each V-series, I think it happens every 2 years or something, is different. I don't think they're connected. They're just basically a more specialized, limited, like a stronger version, a more complex version, a more expensive version than the regular flathead. And I enjoy it. Nothing bad to say about it. I think we're done here. I really enjoyed this. 4/6 is a solid review. It's a really good cigar. Memorable. I won't buy it again because it's limited and you know, and the size is too big for my general liking, but the tobacco and the profile is unique. A lot of flavor. Good amount of healthy amount of spice and but such nice sweet citrus and sweet notes. With the complex wood, cedar, and charred wood, so zero negative. It was a good time. I'm glad I tried it. I'll see you around. You stay fresh. And no cigars in prison.